Hi there! Welcome po ulit sa aking channel, English Bites. Today, ang lesson po natin ay tungkol sa Lesson 4 ng Module 1, Quarter 1 ng English 10, entitled Organizing Panel Discussion and Making Decisions. Tapos na po tayo sa ating Lesson 1, Lesson 2 at Lesson 3 ng Module 1. At then, dito na po tayo sa Lesson 4. Now, before we proceed, dapat po nakahanda na po yung inyong mga module para habang dinidiscuss natin ito, ay masagutan na rin ninyo yung mga activities. Alright, and then also, if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, pakisubscribe na rin po at pakiclick na rin po ang notification bell para palagi kayong updated sa aking next video. Alright, let us now proceed. Lesson 4, Organizing Panel Discussion and Making Decisions. Ito po ang ating introduction dito, hindi na kuna po ito babasahin at diretso na po tayo rito sa objective. After going through this lesson, you will be expected to do the following. First, use information from panel discussions that can be used in everyday life. Next, promote the interest and sense of responsibility in validating the quality of information needed in academic and personal use by managing a panel discussion and develop the abilities to organize information and construct it into a text. Alright, didiretso na po tayo sa importanteng bahagi ng ating lesson kasi mahaba po ito. Hindi na po natin ito pabasahin. May copy naman kayo dyan na inyong mga modules. Diretso na po tayo rito sa may activity na sasagutan. Dito po tayo sa activity 4.1. This time, you will collect information from significant members of your family. Pag sinabi natin significant, it could be either your father or your mother. On the issue about parental capacity in teaching distance learning, tatanungin niyo rito ang inyong mga parents tungkol sa kanilang kakayahan na magturo dito sa distance learning. Interview the members about their stand on the issue. Now, this is the sample interview questions. Kung meron kayong activity worksheets dyan, ay meron din mga questions dyan. But the possible answer, nandito po ang possible answer. So for example, are you a working mother? Can you promise to teach your kids properly? Alright. Siyempre, kung ang parent mo o mother mo ay working mother, nasa opisina siya kung araw, ang sagot niya ay maaaring ganito, I am a working mother, and because of my work, I cannot promise to teach my kids properly. Another question, what would you say if somebody tells you that your strategy in teaching your kids is wrong? So, pwedeng maging ganito ang maging sagot, I am sure that my strategies in teaching my kids is correct and effective. This is quite true. If your parent is professional, say for example, teacher ang parent mo, o kaya professional, nagtatrabaho sa mga opisina, pwedeng ganito ang kailangan maging sagot. But as I've said, the answers may vary. It is always, it depends on your parents, of course. Next, what is it? Panel discussions are useful if an issue is too complex. Ang panel discussion daw ay mahalaga kapag ang issue na pinag-uusapan ay complicated. That is for one person to handle, or if the audience needs to be exposed to various points at the same time, at the same session. Kung ang mga audience ay kailangang ma-expose sila sa iba't ibang mga viewpoints, dapat sila ay manonood dito sa ating panel discussions. Now, to avoid long-winded and disjointed sessions, here are some basic tips to help the audience engage in a meaningful and lively discussion. Number one, keep the panel small and focused. Dapat yung bumubuo ng panel ay maliit lang at nakafocus doon sa pinag-uusapan. Small panel member number will be easy to manage and to flesh out all points of view. Kapag maraming member ang panel, maraming posibleng magsalita ng sabay-sabay. At sa halip na magkaroon ng isang pagkakaunawa ay nagkakabahabahagi. So mas mahalaga kung maliit lang o kukunti lang ang mga member ng panel. Next, number two, plan the questions ahead of time. Dapat yung mga tanong ay pinaplano ng advance. Planning questions will help you bullet some points to discuss during the discussion. Hindi yung kapag nag-uumpisa na yung panel, saka lamang mag-iisip kung anong itatanong. Alright, number three, open with a brief reference to the topic being discussed. It is important to welcome the audience and lead into the topic with a short hook. Dapat bago mag-umpisa yung session, ang leader dito ay meron siyang sinasabi na makaka-attract sa interest ng audience para sila ay maging interesadong manood o makinig sa ginagawang panel discussion. A short a quote, an analogy, or anecdote will warm up the audience and highlight the importance of the event. Dito dapat magaling yung leader na nagsasalita. Pwede siyang magbigay ng isang quote, analogy, or anecdote para magkaroon ng buhay at magkaroon ng interest yung mga nanonood. Number four, keep the focus on the panel, not on you. If you are the leader, dapat nakafocus doon sa buong panel ang atensyon ng audience, hindi doon sa leader. Now, maintain an appropriate tone. Huwag sisigaw na parang nagagalit. Keep people on task. Ito dapat iginagawa ng kinokontrol ng leader. And ensure everyone gets ample time to present his or her point of view. Dapat lahat ng member ay binibigyan ng tamang panahon sa pagsasalita. At huwag basta-basta papayagan yung ibang member na magsalita kahit hindi pa tapos yung sinasabi ng isang panel member. Alright, number five, prepare your cut-off phrases ahead of time. Having some pre-planned cut-off phrases will help filter the long-winded rumble of topics. Dapat merong nakahandang mga cut-off phrases para makontrol yung haba ng oras ng sinasabi ng isang panel member. Using this tactic will keep the discussion focused and on time. Okay. Activity 4.2. Imagine you are one of the classroom officers and you need to address the issue on imposing fines for not wearing school uniform. Now you are going to construct 3 to 5 statements about the problem, about how you will help you manage decision regarding the certain issue. Gagawa kayo rito ng 3 to 5 statements or sentences tungkol sa issue na pinag-uusapan. And here are the possible answers for activity 4.2. Ito na yung pwede ninyong maging answer. Ihanda ang inyong mga ballpen at isulat ito. So number one, students should be allowed to wear type A or type B uniform from Monday to Friday. Pwede ninyong i-revise ito. And then, wearing civilian clothes should not be allowed. Number three, white t-shirts with large prints should not be allowed also. And then, PE uniform should be worn only during PE time. And proper wearing of uniform should be observed at all times. Ito yung mga posibleng answer dito sa activity 4.2. Wala ito dyan sa module ninyo. So, pwede ninyong kopyahin ito. But I'm advising you to just try to rephrase these sentences. Ito ay suggestions ko lang. Okay. Next. What I have learned. Now, for activity 4.3, you are going to fill in the blanks with the correct answer to complete the sentence. Write your answers on your activity sheets. Now, number one, a blank is like a meeting or convention that addresses certain issues or problems with a group of people. Ano ba ito? Kapag nag-meeting ang number of people para pag-usapan yung certain issue, yung pinag-usapan natin kanina, The answer just here is panel discussion. Number two, a blank needs to have a broad perspective and viewpoint, point of view to discuss a certain issue. Ano ba ito? A blank needs to have a broad perspective and point of view to discuss a certain issue. Ito ay panel member. Next, a panel should be small and blank so that it would be easy to understand. Small and ano ito? This should be focused. Number four, it is much better to plan the blank ahead of time to prepare for unexpected topics that may arise during the discussion. Anong answer ninyo rito? It is much better to plan the questions ahead of time. Number five, a good panel member prepares blank phrases. Ano ba yung mga blank phrases kanina na binanggit natin? Ito tinatawag natin na cut-off phrases. Okay. Now, next activity. Activity 4.4. Imagine you are the moderator of a panel discussion. Based on the activity above, you're going to see activity 4.2, yung sinagutan natin. Assume you have heard and gathered the points of views of your members. Make a solution or resolution of at least 5 sentences as basis of your decision making. Now, you are going to write your answers on the worksheet provided for you. Okay. Here are some possible answers to activity 4.4. Pwede mag-iba-iba ang mga sagot ninyo rito. And you can also rephrase these sentences. For number one, outsiders can be easily recognized if students are wearing school uniform. Remember, these are the basis for the decision-making in your panel discussion. Number two, competition of fancy clothes can be avoided if students are in school uniform. Number three, parents can avoid unnecessary expenditures if students are wearing uniforms. Number four, students' identity can be easily recognized through their school uniform. And number five, discrimination can be avoided by means of enforcing wearing of school uniform. Okay. Now, proceed na tayo sa assessment. Now, match column A with column B by writing the letter of the correct answer on the answer sheet provided for you. If you have no answer sheet, pwedeng sa separate sheet of paper ninyo isulat ang sagot. Now, lead. Ano ba itong lead? Okay. Lead is the answers to the questions who, what, where, when, why, and how. So, the answer is letter E. So, number two, headline. Headline is the title of the news article. How about news article? News article can be found in the newspaper. And number four, what is news report? News report is the news information about current events. And factual, of course, ito na yung natira natin, ay itong letter A, relating to facts based on evidence and research. Now, let us proceed to number 6. Read the following questions and write the letter of the correct answer in the answer sheet provided for you. Number 6, which of the following questions answers the specific purpose in persuasive speech? Alin ba rito? Okay. Ang ating keyword dito ay itong word na convince. So, our correct answer is letter A. What are you trying to convince the audience to do? Number 7, the purpose of this type of speech is to convince people or change people in some way to start doing something para magkumbinsi ng tao. So, the correct answer is persuasive, to persuade or to convince. Number 8, the purpose of this type of speech teaches you something that includes a demonstration of how to do a thing. Paano gawin ang isang bagay? Pagka sinabi mong, How to do? Ang keyword dito ay itong how to do. Ibig sabihin, i-demonstrate mo. So, the correct answer is letter A, demonstrative. Number 9. The purpose of this type of speech provides interesting and useful information to the audience. It provides interesting and useful information. So, ang keyword natin dito ay itong information. So, the correct answer is letter C, informative, because of the word information. Number 10, how to bake a cake is a topic that can be used for what type of speech? Itong how to, ito ang answer dito sa pag ikaw ay nagpapakita kung paano gawin ang isang bagay. At pag sinabing paano gawin ang isang bagay, ikaw ay nagdi-demonstrate. So it is letter A, demonstrative. Okay, number 11. It is a type of informative talk that helps the speaker create an accurate mental picture in the mind of an audience regarding a person, place, or thing. Gumagawa ng ano? Accurate mental picture. So, this is descriptive. Nagdi-describe. Nagdi-describe. Naglalarawan ng picture. Okay. Number 12. It is a type of informative talk that explains a state or a thing or phenomenon. So, ito ay nagpapaliwanag ng isang bagay. Okay, so this is letter B, explanatory. And number 13. The following are the tips to help the audience engage in a meaningful and lively discussion, except one. Alin ba rito? Plan the questions ahead of time. Keep the panel small and focused. Keep the focus on your opinion. Prepare cut-off phrases ahead of time. The correct answer is keep on focus on your opinion. Ito lamang ang hindi kasali rito. Sa mga tips to help the audience engage in a meaningful and lively discussion, ang panel member ay hindi dapat nakafocus sa sarili niyang opinion. Kasi pagkaganon ay hindi maganda ang kalalabasan ng panel discussion. Dapat broad-minded ka at pinapakinggan ang opinion ng iba. So, ito ang hindi kasali. So, ito ang tama. Number 14. It is useful if an issue... Okay. Number 14. It is useful if an issue is too complex for one person to handle and the audience needs to be exposed on various viewpoints of the same position. Here, the correct answer is letter D, panel discussion. Ito ang ginagawa kapag gustong malaman o kapag ang isang topic ay too complex, masyadong complicated para lamang sa isang taong panghawakan ito. So, dapat dito ay panel discussion ang maggagawa nito. And number 15, the following characteristics of panel member except one. Ito ang hindi lamang kasali itong opinionated. Kasi hindi dapat maging opinionated ang isang panel member. Dapat broad-minded siya, focus at task-oriented. Hindi siya dapat maging opinionated. Alright? Thank you very much for watching. My next video for English 10 is Quarter 1, Module 2, Lesson 1. Advanced Organizers, Venn Diagram, and Cause and Effect Diagram. See you again on my next video.